welcome back to DillysADV. Today we're doing just a quick review and catch up as far as the progress of things the last couple of weeks. We've been sitting here doing a lot of video editing, trying to filter through what video footage we were able to recover. That said, as we've been doing this, I did record a lot of clips, thinking I knew which direction I was going with the problems we were having, and then come to find out I didn't. So I recorded another clip, and another clip, and another clip. And some of them were updates, some of them were just, hey, I now know what's going on. Nope, I don't know what's going on. I may be wrong, but I doubt it. Need I say more? So anyway, I wanted to share how a lot of that transpired and give you a heads up as to how that worked. And maybe if you start seeing these problems, maybe you can jump right to the conclusion and avoid yourself all the headache that I went through. That said, without further ado, here we go. This is not the adventure I wanted to be dealing with today, but it is an adventure nonetheless. Take a look right over here. This is, you'll know, as a video editor, that's not a site you want to see regularly. The computer's open. Really, this is not the problem. My frustrations this morning come from this little device back here. This is my 3 terabyte external hard drive that I've been using for basically all of my video editing storage. It's 3 terabytes, and I have 2 terabytes are occupied with thousands of videos and picture files and everything else like that. And I can get it to open, I can get it to load, but it's acting not right. Something's messed up on it. I have a 2 terabyte hard drive here, plus I have about another terabyte of storage left on my main storage device in here. So my thought in that is it's probably cheaper and probably easier and probably more energy efficient. And anyway, it's probably an overall better situation to not buy external hard drives, but rather buy more of these. Now, I do have a crap load of them. As far as my computer, the cabinet itself has at least one more bay for full-size hard drive. There you go. And I'm thinking I could actually maybe even have 2 more bays because I have an SSD hard drive that is in a regular bay that probably doesn't need to be in a regular bay. So I can probably undo that. So I could get 2 more drives in there. And that's what I'm thinking I'm going to do. Right now I'm wanting to copy that entire hard drive onto here for the purpose of not losing everything if it really freaks out, and using them to kind of back each other up. In the meantime, I'm going to get probably two 4 terabyte hard drives ordered so that I can put them in here, have one run as just strictly a backup to the other drives, and have one for video editing in the system. It boots up with the computer, I use it with the computer. Today I thought it was locking up because of something like that. So I was fighting with it, unplugged the external hard drive, and it instantly started working. So anyway, so I'm going to try and get this one put in here for now, get it formatted and running, and then see where we go. That should have just added 2 more terabytes of storage. Should have. We'll see. So in working on this though, we got these quick release carriages, which are super cool because you can just pop that out and the carriage slides out. I'll see if I can get it to line back up. And as you can see, it's got the ability to have several of them. This one is my CD-ROM. This one is a USB reader. This one is currently a drawer, which is kind of cool. Empty, SSD, main storage, extra storage, and empty. Okay,
I think we are as good as it's gonna get. Turn power on. Tell me what you think of this. This boot sequence is kind of funny. So, if I've had the power disconnected, let's turn off the music here for a second so we can think. So it'll boot up, and then it should turn off. See, it turns off, and it boots back on. I'm not sure if it's supposed to do that, so if you know, let me know in the comments. And if you know how to fix it, definitely let me know in the comments. Okay, so far everything's booted good. No hiccups that way. Got some background stuff still loading, but let's open this guy. And let's go into computer. Okay, so it's not automatically detecting that drive, and that's something I'm going to have to learn how to do. Come back over here. I'm going to have to learn how to software-wise connect another hard drive. So that's what I'm going to do real quick. I'm going to figure that out, and then we'll come back. Okay, so I'm getting this figured out. Are you recording? Are you recording? So I just pulled up a YouTube video. The guy here is using Windows XP, so this is really old, and he mentioned at the time 2 terabyte was about as big as you're going to get. Times have changed, that is for sure. So basically you go in down here to your start search, and it's CMD. Let me come back to where he posted it so I can just... So it's compmgmt.msc. That's where you go to go into there, then you go into your storage, disk management, and that's what pulls up this. Now we're going to figure out how to do the next step. So here we go. Welcome to the new Simple Volume Wizard. This wizard helps you create simple volumes on a disk. Simple volume can only be on a single disk. So it looks like it's kind of the same thing. It's a newer system. Here you create the partition, Windows XP. A little bit of evolution since then. This one, let me go back through. So you would do new simple volume, hit next. Looks like it's maximum, it's defaulting the maximum, which I want everything on there I can. And hit next. So I'll assign the following drive letter. C, D, E, yeah, let's just do F. That works. And next, format this volume with the following settings. I'm going to leave it as all default because I really don't know what else there is. And next, you successfully completed the new Simple Volume Wizard. There's all the specs. To close this wizard, click Finish. And now it says it's in the process of formatting. And there we go. It's already showing up on the hard drive. So that's really not too bad to do. That is the first time I've added a hard drive to a computer. Like I said, this was custom built by someone else initially. And then when I loaded the software on, it was pretty much already ready to go. So there you go. I may leave that 2 terabyte hard drive in there and continue to use that for my video editing stuff. Maybe. And then just get an extra one for full backup. Or I may go through, I don't know. So let me know what you think. Leave me a note in the comments and tell me what I should do. I just don't know. I know my way around computers enough to get myself in trouble, but that's really about it. They're really not that hard. It's just knowing the tricks that I don't know. So yeah, definitely let me know. And we'll see if this works. This will be the end. If it doesn't work, okay, so I know you're not going to be able to see this really well. I had to power down the external hard drive and reload it a few times to get it to the point where I could get it to respond. I cut my video files, which is just all of the raw videos and I pasted it over into the new drive. Right now it's doing discovering, so I'm really hoping it's going to work and not completely fart out on me. Okay, well, it looks like it's moving it, so stick around. I was just reading a couple things online about the external hard drives. This is the one that has been offering me problems. And they say sometimes it's just the enclosure that's giving you problems, not so much the hard drive itself. So I was just going to open this guy up. I have actually done this. I did this in the past with one of my old Western Digital external drives just because it was small enough that I was finding it was useless at that point. Just trying to get all these clips to release. There we go. So I pretty much broke every one of those clips. Not that that really matters, because for the most part this just sits and does its thing anyway. From here, the next question is, can I remove the hard drive without doing... Whoa. Well, tell you one thing. That bugger's hot. So there is basically a hard drive. Everything else is just case and shock absorber. So what I'm thinking I'm going to do is I'm going to let this guy cool down for a while. While it's cooling down, I'm going to get everything pulled out so I can access it better, because the power cord's stuck back there further. And try and access it then. If I can access it then, I'm going to pull this hard drive out and see if I can hook it directly into the computer. I want my data off of here. To have almost 3 terabytes worth of video files for the past several years. I mean, we're going back, I think I go back as far as, yeah, about 2012 on videos on here. It's 2017 now. So 5 years worth of videos. Got to get them off of here. And I've been trying, as I started doing this, I've been trying to move these, a lot of them, to my archive channel on YouTube. Some are private, some are public. But apparently I wasn't fast enough. Well, we'll see. Let that cool down for a while. Then we'll come back at it. Alright, so, just a quick update. We've been pretty much at this all day long, and it looks like it is the actual hard drive having a hard time itself. And I recorded a separate video, but now I've just been able to confirm it. It looks like heat may be a big factor. I brought this old fan out, kicked it on, blowing right on it. And so far, if I turn you back over here so you can kind of see these monitors. That should be about there. It looks like it's working reasonable. I'm trying to only move a couple files at a time because it is still slow, but keeping it cool is definitely making a difference. So there you go. That is one thing you can try if you have a hard drive that's acting up. Get a fan on it, get it as cool as you can, and do what you can to get it out. So there you go. Okay, well, it's now the next day. We were able to get quite a few files moved last night. I made the call to turn it all off. Go to bed at about 11:30 last night, and because I knew there was no way I was going to be able to get it all done last night. And now this morning, it is not recognizing pretty much anything. It comes up and says the drive needs to be formatted, that sort of stuff. I've tried a few different options with running, you know, the check disk, and I've tried what was the other program I was using? Find and mount wasn't adequate. Right now I'm using EaseUS Data Recovery Wizard. It may work. So it could be a hardware issue, could be software issue. Right now we're looking at software issues to see if it'll recover anything. I have no idea how long this is going to take. So I'm going to move on to some other things while it does its job, and we'll go from there. We'll see. Today, we're giving you just a little bit of an update. Over the past 48 hours, we've been having some IT issues. Pretty much what it is, all my videos are being stored on a external hard drive, Seagate. 3 terabytes. Long story short, we've learned some information that we're going to pass along to you. Because if it's valuable to me, it's probably going to be valuable to at least one of you. What this is going to basically take into consideration is what kind of hard drives you should have if you're doing anything, really. So really what this comes down to is a lot of people have computers. But that being said, I've got some tips on how you should probably set up your computer to prevent problems. And I'm going to share those with you. So stick around and we'll go through this step by step. But until then, we'll see you next time. Oh well. Because life's an adventure.